Hello and thanks for watching Proactive New York. Ondine Biomedical is up with results from its phase two photodisinfection study. With more, I'm joined by the company's president and chief technology officer, Dr. Nicolas Loebel. Nicolas, very good to speak with you today.
Thank you, Steve. Much appreciated.
So the results say that you met the primary endpoint of the study. Could you go into a bit more detail about this, please?
Thank you. The BENEFIT-APDT study was designed to demonstrate how well photodisinfection works as an antimicrobial. So to eradicate microbes in the nose, which would potentially infect a patient in intentional surgical wounds. In particular, we focused on the microbe Staphylococcus aureus, which is the single most important, the worst pathogen, if you will, involved in these surgical site infections. And so the endpoint of the study did focus on how well we eradicated Staphylococcus aureus from the noses of these patients.
Nick, why are surgical site infections such an important area to focus on?
They are really infections that shouldn't exist. They are infections created within the healthcare system for one reason or another, related to the pre-surgical preparation of the patient, the absence of nasal decolonization. These are generally microbes picked up from the surface of the patient. These are normally so-called commensal or healthy microbes on the surface of the skin. However, after an incision has been made through the skin, they can enter the bloodstream. And there, they can turn from commensal, good bugs, to pathogens, bad bugs. And really, the surgical site infection exposes the patient to a very dangerous form of infection called bacteremia, where the blood becomes septic. Microorganisms start to replicate within the bloodstream. You are essentially a bag of warm, wet, sugar-filled fluid, and the bugs love it. And so once that happens, you can get into very serious trouble. And especially if those microbes carry antibiotic resistance genes, it may not be possible to save you. That's where we're focused.
Nick, can you explain why the study focused on Staphylococcus aureus?
Well, Steve, as I said, the primary organism implicated in these types of infections is, in fact, Staph aureus. There are many different staphylococci, but Staph aureus has the largest number of virulence factors, and it's one of the most aggressive microbes. It also is the subject of our fast track and QIDP approvals by FDA, where we are required now to look at that microbe in particular and suppress that microbe. Of course, photodisinfection benefits over many other, if not all, forms of therapy by being so broad spectrum. We do kill Pseudomonas, we do kill Acinetobacter, we kill all the bugs that are otherwise involved in infections, which are other than Staph, but we're focused on one as essentially a proving mechanism, as a regulatory proof that we can really do a good job on that bug, besides the fact that it is quite so lethal and because it involves quite so many antibiotic-resistant genes.
Well, now that you've concluded the phase two trial, what's the next step towards completing the FDA regulatory process, Nick?
Well, the study is actually just wrapping up in terms of the secondary endpoint analyses. We will be looking at subgroup analyses, et cetera. And then we're wrapping that entire outcome set into what's called a clinical study report, which is destined for the FDA. The agency will review that report. We will be requesting a end of phase two meeting shortly, where the FDA is essentially provided with a report of all our prior investigations, our future expectations, and we will be asking FDA for permission to proceed in multiple directions, but primarily towards a pivotal study. And they will then review all of the information that we provided them with an eye to that endpoint.
I hope you'll keep us updated on any progress. Thank you very much for the update today, though.
Thank you, Steve. Much appreciated.
Dr. Nicolas Loebel is the President and Chief Technology Officer at Ondine Biomedical.